Hi, I'm Sean Hess. I'm the broker of St. Augustine Team Realty in St. Augustine, Florida. This is...
I'm Kate Stevens, Sean's business associate.
And the broker associate of St. Augustine Team Realty. Today we're going to talk about what are the first things you do as a first-time buyer. And I'm going to look at the little camera here, get real up close, and see if we can try and keep this under 5 minutes. So make it easy for you. But the first thing I would suggest is if you're a first-time buyer, you're considering buying a home for the first time, is determine if you really are going to live in that home for the next 3 years, or that neighborhood for the next 3 years that you're looking at. Because if you don't think you are, you've just taken your first job or a new job in a new town, say you moved to St. Augustine for the first time, I would actually advise you to rent for a year first. Get to know the town, get to know the areas you like, the places you hang out, before you ever buy anything.
We have the market sort of, one of the advantages of a slow price market is that you're not losing ground in that year. You're paying mm-hmm. rent, and you're not really going to be missing out as house prices shoot up over the next year. So you have that luxury to be able to rent somewhere, find your feet, make sure you're more comfortable before you make a bigger commitment to the area.
Also, it gives you a lot of time to do research on the area. It does do research on the loan. There's a big chicken and the egg question. Do you go find a mortgage lender first to get you pre-qualified, which a lot of realtors would love, or do you find the realtor first and get the loan as you're trying to find a house? And it really, the first year you want to do is you just want to make sure that you like where you're living, that if you do think this is where I'm going to be for the next 3 years, that your job security is stable enough, because if you lose your job in a year, or you don't like it in a year, and you've only owned the house 12 months or 8 months, you're going to go into a hole selling it, because you're not going to be able to get the closing costs back unless, say, you bought a very distressed property, fixed it up, and are able to get some equity out that way. You know, the downside to having price stability is that there's price stability, which means you're not going to lose anything by maybe waiting a year as we shoot this video, you're also not going to gain much either. So it might take 3 years to gain back the closing costs that you would pay on a sale, or even the closing costs you paid on a loan. So that's the first step.
And
so,
like Sean said, it is a little chicken and egg. You know, should I go talk to somebody about a mortgage, or should I find a house I like first? And it's a bit of a gray area. Ideally, we'd like everybody to come to us nicely pre-approved from a mortgage lender. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people, you know, they get attracted by a house and you know, get tired paying rent and want to get the ball rolling. And it doesn't hurt to to look at a couple of properties ahead of time. But really, fairly on in the process, you do need to talk to a mortgage person about what your options are. Just because you've been paying however much a month in rent for the last 100 years does not necessarily mean you're going to qualify for a mortgage in this ever-changing and ever-tightening mortgage market.
Correct.
Different types of properties are harder to finance than others. Mobile homes, extremely difficult right now. Condos typically require more money down than most first-time buyers have. Some are almost impossible. Some fixer-uppers are not available without at least a good 20% down. So that's kind of an irony of the market right now, is a lot of first-time home buyers see a home that is a good price, but because of their financing options that are available to them, they would never be able to buy it because the financing insists that the house is in fairly decent shape.
Absolutely. The thing about, another thing you want to be doing is you want to be building a down payment. You want to be saving for a down payment. I think about the minimum you get away with. Now, there is 100% financing, what's called true 100% financing through a program called USDA. But most of the time, you're going to be in a conventional program or FHA. FHA is a minimum of 3.5% down. A conventional loan could require anything. It could be about 5%, 10%, 20%, depending on the property. As Kate said, a mobile home, a condo, and a single family home, or a certain type of single family home, are all going to have different criteria on how much you have to bring to the table in terms of a down payment. So you want to be creating a down payment by saving money. And you also want to be creating a cash reserve, if possible, of at least 6 months in case you lose your job, to make your house payments, to cover anything that breaks down. Because we've done we've done blog posts on, okay, you can expect these 5 things to break down during your home ownership. You know, your water heater, your AC unit, there's going to be a plumbing issue, there might be, I don't know, stucco cracks or whatever. But there's going to be maintenance issues that you'll be paying on a house, whether it's a brand new house or it's an older house that you simply won't be able to escape and you're going to need some kind of cash reserve for. The same type of cash reserve you don't need when you're renting because you just call the landlord or the apartment community manager or whatever. So those are things to think about. What else? So
we've kind I would of, say you just be, you know, pick an area that you like. I mean, you have to be realistic. If you really want to live in a certain neighborhood and you talk to a mortgage person and those houses are more expensive than you're qualified for, you have to be realistic. We are seeing a market now where well-priced properties are, for the first time in a long time, receiving multiple offers. You can't always assume that you can offer 20, 30, 10,000, even less than asking price. We're seeing homes going for several thousand dollars more than asking price sometimes if they were competitively priced out of the gates. So you do have to be realistic about your options. Everybody wants a $400,000 house for $175,000, but you do have to be realistic about what your options are, especially when you're using financing.
As a first-time buyer, one of the things you might want to look for, getting aside from neighborhood, is if you can find it in your price range. Is something like a four-bedroom home that's fairly recently built, and we're shooting this in 2012. So let's say built since 2005 or 2006. And what that does, the fourth bedroom, increasingly people need home offices. They need three bedrooms, and they need an additional office. So you find a home with three bedrooms and say that has an extra office or an extra bedroom or a formal dining room that nobody's using. That's going to be good from a resale standpoint. The problem with it in the present standpoint is if you're living alone or you're a new married couple and it's your first house, you're going to be bumping around with a lot of extra space. But the expectation is if your family grows, you'll have room to grow into the house. And if you need to move, it will be one of the most attractive homes on the market in a resale standpoint because it will already have three bedrooms and an office. That being said, most people, when they buy any house at any stage, whether they're a first-time buyer or 15th-time buyer, is buy what they like. So in other words, we advise you to buy a four-bedroom, two-bath house so you can resell it easier in 4 years and make it newer so you won't be putting on a roof and that the appliances won't wear out while you're there and that you won't have to replace those before you sell it next time. But you fall in love with a two-bedroom, two-bath shotgun bungalow.
Like me.
Like her. Kate loves old houses. Always has, always will, and that's what she's going to buy. So if you fall in love with a old house, buy an old house because after all you're going to be living in it 3 to 5 years and you want to enjoy it there. I mean, maybe that's better for you than thinking, okay, 5 years, yeah, I might sell it, but you know, I'm going to have to live in this big house that Sean recommended and I'm just going to be bumping around in it. You know, it's in Pickwick Acres, the brand new subdivision, and I don't like Pickwick Acres. I like old, cool looking Victorian style houses. So I mean, you know, and that's the way most people honestly buy. You know, they give you something on paper, but the good agents have to go, it's like, okay, well, I know that this is the one house they ain't gonna buy. So we gotta find really what they're buying, you know, and this is where we start. So we take them, show them what they want on paper, and then you discover it. So anyway, I hope that's helpful. Did you have anything else to add before I cut this out?
Not really.
We might actually do another video on this, like a little more detailed on looking for that very first house, but I don't think we're gonna do it here. We're just gonna end right here. So if you have any questions for us, we're in St. Augustine, Florida. We are St. Augustine Team Realty. And our contact information will be after this, but you can find us on the web at saintaugteam.com is the short way, or St. Augustine Team Realty. Spell it just like it sounds, except Saint is S-T. So thank you for watching.
Bye.